today is a wonderful day for me to be here and have a chance to do a presentation. My topic is social media is the root cause of human intervention. So let's start with this. Social media have a lot of advantages and disadvantages for the nature. But one thing doesn't always come with all the helpful benefits. There is always a negativity coming from or after. And as a student and in my teenage year, I have found it slowly destroying our honorable lives. So before we change to the topic above, we should first understand the keyword of my topic. What exactly does the word social media, image, and depression mean? The word social media is a push internet platform in this century, and we can use it on our phone, computers, laptops, and other devices. And also the word image, it means adolescent, which is also mean teenage people, and a year that between 15 years old. And next, the word depression is relating to the feeling and also making you feel upset or stressed. And so in this topic, I have divided into three reasons, and it affects the degree. And without any delay, let's begin with the first reason with me altogether. First, social media contains information such as that are not good for nature, such as harmful use, cyberbullying, traumatic and cross info is what. And for info is what, right? And as a teenager, they are easily falling into those and cause them a mental breakdown after they reading, watching, or listening to those. And the second point is talking about teenagers spend a lot of time on the social media, since the social media become popular. And also our daily routine change. Most of us used to be active, but now they are away with the phone, staying up all day just to check their phone, scrolling up and down, playing games, and watch videos on the internet. And third, got lost. We watch our daily busy routine change, and we started to feel like we don't know what to do next thing, and got lost, and we do something that helps our life become better. And one thing that I got many shares on the internet, it talks about education, knowledge, or life experience. Some of them just take our time wasting on it, and also our work doesn't that. And we can, and then we got depression or stress on us. And last but not least, social media is one of the cause of teenage depression. And it's gradually killing our mental health. And so people or teenage in any ages should not focus and spending a lot of time on it due to the problem it has provided. Thank you, everyone, to pay attention to listen to my topic.
More calories. when we eat breakfast every day, it can help us ready our body to burn the calorie. And it is a crucial fact for people to know, especially if they are trying to diet or lose weight. For people that want to be diet, breakfast is really good for them because it really burns the calorie really well. Yes. And also if they are working out or do the exercise, it will help them to lose weight faster. And the second point I will want to tell you is breakfast will make us less tired during the day. When breakfast consists of items like rice, milk, bread, or anything else that are good for our health, it means that we are filling our body the entire morning. And research has discovered that breakfast also can help us to boost concentration. Students that are at 8 breakfast every day in the morning have better memory, concentration, attention, and school achievement than those who consume to eat breakfast only sometime or never did. And in conclusion, I would like to say that no matter how busy we are, we should spend 5 to 10 minutes to eating our breakfast every day because it's really important for our health. And thank you. Finally, thank you for all of you that listened to me and paying your attention.
Teacher, and hello all my dear classmates. Today I come here to present our few of our topics, advantages and disadvantages of using mobile phone. As we know, nowadays there are a lot of people are using mobile phone, and a few people don't have mobile phone or not using mobile phone. And another name for mobile phone is cell phone. And today mobile phone has become a popular advice for everyone to use it, and it is easy to communication with the purpose and for the activity. We know that everything has its own extreme, good and bad, and somehow it's good and somehow it's bad too. And for the mobile phones, and on the other hand, it includes the worst thing you need too. So now let's move to advantages of using mobile phone. The advantages of using mobile phone is you can communicate all over the world with your family or your friends without electricity. And no matter where you are, you can contact with them easily by using mobile phone to connect to them. And you can relate with your mobile phone app, like listen to music and play games, watching TV, play Facebook, or you can chat with your friend everywhere. And along with the benefit of using mobile phone, there are also disadvantages too. Using mobile phone, it can harm your brain, particularly with children and teenagers who are under 16 years old. If you use mobile phone too much, it can affect for your eye and your ear problem when you are listening to music or when you are calling with headphones. And in conclusion, mobile phone has really important in the life. So if you using mobile phone too much, it really affects for you. And it also has a lot of benefit of using mobile phone too. And if you use mobile phone, you should know about the side of them in order to make the wonderful advice. And you should use it limited, not use it for a long time. And you can use it for a long time, and you don't get addicted to it too much. That's all for my presentation. Thank you, teacher, and thank you everyone for your time. Thank you. they need to study more by themselves in order to catch up the lesson. Students also have much more free time to read more books, do more exercises, which help them learn more effectively. Normally, when students study at home, they also can do online research so that they can understand about the lesson more clearly. Moreover, when students study at school, they also have some time to have their parents to do housework. Study online is much more easier than study at school. So now I'm going to talk about the disadvantages of study online. When we study online, the teacher and student are away from each other, which is difficult for teacher to control. And one more thing is lack of teaching material. This means that the teacher cannot use the whiteboard to teach or write like they do in the classroom. In contrast, they can set screen by using a whiteboard from Zoom, which is not difficult, which is not effective as study at the classroom. Especially, so many parents are concerned about the health of having their children staring. Spend so many hours staring at the screen. It's one of the biggest concerns and disadvantages of study online. In conclusion, study online has its own advantages and disadvantages. That's all of my presentation. Thank you for paying attention.
My topic is right to the left of charity. First, I would like to tell you what is charity. Charity is an organization that is able to help society for poverty and all. Giving to charity is not a transaction, it is a connection between humans and the world. Charity is not only money that we can donate to charity. It has some food, clothes, or accessories that we never use. The donation doesn't have limited. We can donate something as possible as we can and generously. Now I have three reasons why we should donate to charity. First, small donations have a huge impact and beneficial for many people. Even if just a small donation, but it can help people with something that they never have or they want it, and it also make them happy. And you might never know the difference you have brought in the life of a person. The charity always beneficial for people who need it the most. And second is helping the poor and reduce poverty. The only one of the purpose of charitable donation is to help the poor. The reason that we should donate to charity is to remove poverty. With charity, we can help people fight disease and send their children to school. If they don't spend money on this medicine, they will be able to get out of poverty. And the third is create a better world. Charity can make this world a better place. Charity can make this world a better place. If you want this world, poverty is the biggest reason that makes this world lead to crimes. If you want to make this world a better place, donating to charity is the best solution. When people get employed, they want to become criminals and the world will be filled with positivity. In conclusion, donation to charity is very important for people poverty or needing people. It's not only people but also animal and human organization need our help. And during this COVID-19, you can still donate some money to charity school online. They all of my presentation. Thank you for your listening.
Hi, hello everyone. Today I'm very excited to have presentation and the title is How to be good at studying English. In Cambodia, English is the second language that has a lot of students study. And it's a very important language that has a lot of people around the world for study. It's important like when they go to another country, they need to communicate with each other by using English language. And for today, I have
I want to share with you about some tips that how to be good at studying English. And the first, my point is focus on core skills, and the second is practice every day. Now let's go to the first main point. Focus on core skills, like English is, it has four main skills like reading, listening, writing, and speaking. For reading, we can learn by your own. Just read newspaper or some book, and if you don't know some words, you can take listen Greek, and it will help you to improve your pronunciation too. And one more is listening. You can listen to your teacher or listen to English song. And the next is read. And the next is writing. You can write some words that you don't know or write a short paragraph. The last is speaking. You have to have conversation with your friend or every people around you. Don't waste the time. Let's go to the second point. The second point is practice every day. And if you know about first year already, but you don't practice it, you will forget it in one day. And I recommend all of you to practice it. Like when you study at school already, you have to take the lesson, the study at school, to practice at home every day. And this is one of the parts that can help you to improve your English. And don't forget, and everyone don't forget to improve your pronunciation or grammar, because it's really important to talk with people or make the sentence. And that's all for my presentation. Thank you everyone. In conclusion, I want to say that this topic is one of the parts that can help you to improve your study English is well, and I want to tell you that to try to study hard and pay attention on your study. That's all for my presentation. Thank you for your listening.
Developing country, acquiring technology, sport, and something else are very important now. If we want our country to become developed country, we should support someone or something that help the team to develop our country. Myanmar nowadays, e-sport or electronic export in Cambodia is developing. But there are many professional players, but they aren't really good enough. Therefore, they have to a tournament with another country. But because the country is very good at e-sport, and people in another country is very supportive. Cambodian people should support e-sport too, but we have to support e-sport. This is important. My answer is yes. In another end, to support my topic and the rest two reasons why we have to support e-sport in Cambodia. The first reason is improve our professional pleasure to become better. They are professional players, but why do we still support them? Yes, they are professional players, but they also have some mistakes which they don't know. To correct their mistakes, they have to practice and train every day. Therefore, they don't have time to do something else or earning money. If they don't have money or food, how can they have feeling to try and practice? Provide this program, we can support them by just sending money to them in Facebook when they are living, or send them money in another app like KDAB. And more than that, if we can support them by sending money, we just motivate them and encourage them, not just look down or criticize. Example, at 8 November 2021, our candidate team has Romania and country, but they were fell and were dying. And candidate people not just feel done, just motivate and encourage them to be present and practice us every day. And the second reason is it's what is also help serving our country to international stage. As we know, it's what is also part of sport. Consistently establishing our name to international stage. It's our international team able to win. It's also our chance to another country to know our country and also down here another country just look down our country, and it's also every other country also known our country like as a outstanding country with esports. In conclusion, I think consider every sport, including e-sport, is also should be supported by people in competition, not to make them feel better, not just look down or criticize them to make them feel worse. And that's all for my presentation. Thank you, everyone, for listening.
And my first keyword is Explore, it means that travel some in order to know or to learn about something.
Yes.
And the second keyword is communication. Communication is mean that exchanging the information by writing, listening, or speaking. Yes. And now please move to my first main point is improve communication skill. As the world begins to open up in 2021, travel and exploring is the famous thing that people around the world like to do. And as well as the country where English is main language, such as United Kingdom, United States, New Zealand, Canada, and Australia. And knowledge of English equip you the tool to travel and communication more effectively in so many parts of the world, and which allow you to explore and travel more confidently and learn more about the country or the culture that you visit. And now please move to my second point, is talking about explore the world with confidence. When you learn English as a second language, you are also learning the new way to think and express yourself more better. Learning multiple languages can help you communicate more clearly and ask the language that you learn and know about the language, how it works and how it used, and to communication with all kinds of social, educational, and the professional setting. And in my conclusion, I suggest to all of you that you should not skip the English, even though you study per 1 hour or 2 hours per day, because nowadays English is the important language that we need to learn. Yes. That's all for my presentation. Thank you for the listening.
And phones to tap with, to tap and call with. Thank you. to the film that we come. Okay, see, we get COVID-19. We have to know.